Looks like we found the right tower. Come on, laddie.
Timekeeper, the flow of time, of destiny. I watch over them, guide them.
But what are you?
I am just what I say I am, and that is all I am.
I hope you don't mind us intruding, but we heard there might be a rather special light here in the tower that can... well, that can... bring people back. We've lost someone very special, you see, and... well, we were hoping you might be able to help us.
You speak of time sphere. If you were to harness its power, that which you seek might be attained. But to lose time is to lose much. The path you propose to follow is not one to be trodden lightly.
To lose time? What do you mean?
Time sphere is the crystallization of all that has taken place in Erdria since memory began. Each moment gathered by the spirits of lost time, savored, remembered. To take a sword to the sphere would be to erase those moments, to return to the time of the last intact memory. If your companion is to be restored to you, time itself must be destroyed. As I say, to lose time is to lose much.
So in order to save Veronica, we would need to turn back time.
I think I'm beginning to get the picture. We'd need to go back to... We'd need to go back to before Yggdrasil fell. That way, we could stop Mordiggin before it was too late. That wouldn't just save Veronica. It would save the whole of Erdrea. Think of all the pain and suffering we could prevent.
It is possible. All is possible. It may be that returning to that particular fork in the flow of time brings all that you wish and more.
But it must be done. I would gladly give up all that has happened since that day for the chance to change it.
Aye.
Alas, to lose time is to lose much. Only one of you may return to that place. The sphere can be broken but once, by a single hand. A hand possessed of a singular power. In this world, only one such power exists. That of the Luminary. I see you. I know you. I knew you the moment you appeared. Only you can break the sphere, and only with the Sword of Light. When it is broken, when the memories are shattered, you will return to the past, and there you will stay.
You mean he'll have to live it all again? He can't come back here, to us?
To lose time is to lose much. This world, this reality, these will be lost to you. And that is not all. The outcome of the sphere's shattering is impossible to foresee. You may be lost forever, trapped in a corner of time, a half-faded memory.
That's awful!
Your present, your companions, your life even, all these may be lost to you. Knowing this, are you willing to risk all for the sake of your departed friend? Only you can decide. I will await you before the sphere.
I'm sorry, but you simply can't do this. We won't let you.
Thank you.
Okay, okay. You win. We know you well enough by now not to try and talk you out of this. But you'd better not mess this up. You go back there and you save her, you hear? Save us all.
Do what you have to do. We won't stand in your way. The decision is made. Then you must know all that I know. To lose time will be to lose much. But some semblance of your present self will remain. Your memories, the record of your adventures thus far. Your knowledge of battle, and all that you have learned. And last of all, the containers that surround the altar. These are the time capsules. These sacred vessels are immune to the flow of time. When you shatter the sphere, all that you possess will be placed within them. Thus, may the items you require journey with you to the past. Alas, there is one item that will not survive the journey. The Sword of Light. But you should retain possession of its twin, the Sword of Shadows. This will surely prove to be a more than worthy weapon for the time being. Now you know all that I know. All else is unknowable. When you are ready, join me by the sphere. Step forward. Luminary, and into the past.
Wait!
When you meet me in the past, we will be enemies again. But know this, I stand ready to pledge myself to your cause once more, to be your sword, your shield, your unswerving companion.
Yes, yes, very dramatic, Hendrik, honey. Now, if you've quite finished frowning and swearing oaths,
farewell, darling. I look forward to seeing you in the past.
I know you can do this. I know you won't let anything stand in your way. And the us's of the past will be there for you whenever you need us. Now, if I know your grandfather, he'll have a few words to say before you go.
You've grown into a fine figure of a man, laddie. Oh, don't look down now. We'll only be apart a wee while. We're back there waiting for you after all. You'll do us proud. I know you will. How could you not do? You're my own flesh and blood after all.
I suppose I began this journey with you, feeling that I was simply doing my duty. But it became so much more than that. I'll never forget the time we've spent together. So please, if you don't mind, I hope you'll take me along with you, all over again.
The time of departure is upon us. Luminary, take the Sword of Light in hand.
Wait, laddie. Oh. 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 Oh.
This isn't goodbye. Not by a long shot. See you on the other side.
And remember, we'll be waiting for you.
Take this cur, this harbinger of calamity, and cast him into the furthest corner of the dungeon.
Let's do this. I believe in you. I believe in the Luminary.
We of Arborea swear to protect you. While we live, none shall defeat you.
Friends, shipmates, amigos, Svarthrust and the Rainbow await! Destiny beckons!
I don't know how Mordigan's planning on achieving eternal life, but I know one thing. We're going to stop him.
You must defeat him. The fate of our world depends upon it. Good luck.
Thank you.